Hey guys and welcome back. My name is Caleb. In today's video I'm going to show you a quick tip on how to improve SSD write performance under Fedora. We'll take a look at how to enable fstrim and how it not only improves SSD write performance but also extends their expected lifetime. Okay, so SSD drives tend to be much faster compared to traditional rotating hard drives. However, what most people probably don't know is that SSD write speeds can significantly slow down over time as the drive gets used. How can that be? Let me first explain what's going on, and then we can look at how to fix this in Fedora by using periodic fstrim. SSDs use a memory type called NAND memory. It's very fast to read and write, but it has a quirk. The memory area that's being written has to be erased first. This is different from regular spinning hard drives, where data can be directly overwritten without needing to be erased first. When reading or writing, NAND memory uses a data unit called a page, which is the smallest unit it can address. However, when doing an erase operation, it can only erase a larger data unit called a block. Each block consists of a number of pages. When an SSD drive comes out of the factory, all of the NAND memory on it is in the erase state. This means that any writes are super fast because they don't need an erase operation first. However, as the SSD fills up and starts running out of empty erased pages, things change. Let's say it needs to update a single page that has existing data on it and is not in an erase state. To be able to do that, it first has to erase the whole block that contains that page. The other pages in that block, however, may still have valid data on them. So it first needs to read back all of the old data that was in that block, then erase the whole block, then write back all of the old data, and only then it can go and write the page it needed to update in the first place. It's easy to see how having to do all of that makes things slower. Beyond that, it also causes additional write operations because the SSD needs to read back and rewrite all of the existing data that was on that block that got erased. The NAND memory on SSD drives only has limited read-write cycles, and doing them unnecessarily can reduce the expected lifetime of the whole SSD drive. This read, erase, write back sequence is called write amplification, and it's the reason why SSDs can considerably slow down as they get filled up. In order to avoid write amplification, almost all SSD drives internally reserve some of their capacity and only make it accessible to the SSD controller. The controller can then use those reserved blocks to always keep a pool of empty erased blocks around. As long as it has access to some pre-erased blocks, it can logically remap any writes to the pre-erased blocks and use that to avoid issues with write amplification and make writes fast. Logically remapping writes also makes it possible for the controller to do wear leveling, which also helps avoid issues with reduced lifetime. This is the reason why SSDs often have odd sizes such as 240 GB. Chances are that it's actually a 256 GB drive. It's just that 16 GB of those are internally reserved and only accessible to the controller. However, those 16 GB of already erased blocks can easily run out if you need to quickly write a lot of data. And once the supply of erased blocks is exhausted, you can expect the write speeds to slow down a lot. So what can we do on the software side to improve this? One solution is for the operating system to tell the SSD controller which data areas on file systems are no longer used and no longer contain valid data, such as after deleting files. This operation is called trim. Trimming allows the SSD to pre-erase blocks that don't contain valid data and use those for when it needs to sustain a large amount of writes. It can also use those to improve wear leveling. In Fedora 32, we are going to globally enable a periodic service that does exactly this. It's a systemctl timer called fstrim.timer. It runs weekly and each time looks through all of the mounted file systems and then sends trim commands to the SSD to let it know which blocks can be safely erased. This should make it much less likely that people run into issues with write amplification and SSD write speeds dropping. Fedora 32 is, however, still in development and only scheduled for release at the end of April. If you are a Fedora user watching this, chances are that you are still on Fedora 30 or 31. If you want to get the speed improvements that fstrim gives already now, there's no need to wait until Fedora 32 is released. It's very easy to enable the fstrim timer manually. Let's jump in the computer and let me show you how to do that. Okay, so I'm in Fedora 31 here. First, let's open Terminal. Here I'll type systemctl list timers. The fstrim timer doesn't show up in the list, which means that it's currently disabled. To enable it, I'll type systemctl enable dash dash now fstrim.timer. We can now look at the list of systemctl list timers again, which shows that the timer is now enabled. The timer runs on a weekly basis, every Monday night, and activates fstrim.service. If the computer is turned off at the time the timer is scheduled to run, it just runs at the first boot. Since I don't want to wait until next Monday, I'll just start it now so that we can see what it does. Systemctl start fstrim.service. This takes a few seconds and runs the exact same command that we scheduled with fstrim.timer. If I now type journalctl -b -u fstrim.service, it now shows the output from fstrim and how much data was trimmed from various file systems. All of the trimmed data was returned to the empty pool and can be now used by the SSD controller to optimize writes. And that's it. Now the timer automatically runs every week in the background and makes the file systems on the SSD faster.
You might ask, are there any downsides to SSD trimming? There are a few to think of, but they shouldn't affect most people, and we've decided to go ahead with enabling fstrim globally for all of Fedora 32. The first downside is that after issuing trim, it becomes almost impossible to recover any previously deleted data. If you ever end up accidentally deleting something important and need to attempt recovery, it's probably a good idea to disable the fstrim timer as a first thing before it has a chance to run. Second, if you are dealing with encrypted file systems, trim can leak information about the file system layout. This is by no means leaking actual data, but it can give some additional clues to the attacker, such as the file system type used, or even just show that there is a file system on the device and it doesn't just contain random data. And third, on some older devices that don't support qtrim, issuing a trim command can cause a few seconds of lockups as the drive needs to flush its entire command queue. However, since the fstrim timer runs during the night and only once a week, most people shouldn't notice this at all. And it's a non-issue on newer devices. Before I finish this video, I'd like to give a shout out to the always awesome Chris Murphy from the Fedora Workstation group, who did the work of enabling fstrim timer for Fedora 32. Thank you, Chris, for making Fedora better. And that's it for today. If you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up here on YouTube and also share it with other Fedora users you know. This helps me get the message out and more people can benefit from faster SSDs under Fedora. Thank you so much for watching and bye for now.